This is a short presentation to give an impression of the Dynamic Adaptive Policy Pathway Method, or DAPP. The Adaptive Pathways approach is modeled on the idea of a metro map. Its essence are sequences of measures over time, or pathways, that reach specified objectives. What you see here on the axis are changing conditions. So for this example, let's assume this is sea level rise. Okay, if you look at the current situation, you see that after a certain amount of sea level rise, a tipping point is reached. This is analogous with an end terminal in a metro map. If we consider a flood risk objective, this essentially means that at this point, the flood risk simply becomes too high and action needs to be taken. In this illustration, there are four potential actions. Actions A and D are robust. They can withstand a lot of sea level rise and still meet flood risk objectives. This could be, for example, elevating roads and houses. The downside of these types of options is that they're usually expensive, have large social impact, and may turn out to be an overinvestment. Other options are short-term actions, like action B. This could be, for example, the installation of booster pumps to improve drainage capacity. These actions are usually more easily implemented and they buy us time, but they don't typically have a very long shelf life. In this example, once action B reaches its tipping point, it needs to be augmented by action A or D. These sequences of actions over time are what we refer to as pathways. The future is deeply uncertain. The timing of changing conditions like sea level rise is unknown. In the DAPP approach, this means transitions between actions may be needed sooner or later, depending on how the future unfolds. But the pathways themselves remain unchanged, making DAPP a robust planning method under deep uncertainty. Each of the pathways meets the same specified objectives over the entire time horizon, but they each come with different costs, benefits, and co-benefits, which are used to evaluate, together with stakeholders and decision makers, which pathway is most preferred. So, where have we applied DAPP? At the San Francisco Public Utility, where they need to manage demand and supply under a myriad of uncertain future conditions. In Calcasieu Parish, Louisiana, for a 10-watershed master plan for flood resiliency under climate change. In Miami, together with the South Florida Water Management District, to update flood mitigation strategies under rising sea levels. And then the Netherlands, where DAPP was developed. The Netherlands is known as a pioneer in innovative and forward-thinking flood resilience. And DAPP is the method they've used to plan for flood protection and water supply over the next 100 years. In Bangladesh, where socioeconomic development is a key driver. In the Philippines, under limited data and financial resources. In New Zealand, which has resulted in the prescription of DAPP in the National Guidance on Adaptation Measures. It is fit for purpose, meaning it can be tailored to the data and resources available and can be as qualitative or quantitative as needed. It is structured and tested, which means you can rely on the process and the outputs. It is adaptive. We don't know how the future will unfold, but the pathways approach is robust under uncertainty. Stakeholder engagement is built into the method, from the inception of the objectives to the decision about which measures to consider to the final pathway selection. And finally, DAPP facilitates communication with the public. While the metro map infographic is based on complex assessments, the graphic itself is intuitive and easily understood by anyone. It provides transparency and clarity of decisions and helps with public buy-in.